All right, in this video, we are going to look at solving by graphing. When you are taking notes and listening to this video, please make sure you have the correct page of notes. It should look like what you see currently on your screen. All right, so it says at the top that a quadratic equation is an equation that can be written in the standard form of ax squared plus bx plus c equals 0, where a does not equal 0. So there must be a quadratic term. There has to be something there to the second power. And we cannot have anything over the second power. So no x to the third, x to the fourth, anything like that. So for the first example on your notes page, I did that page for you, or I did that example for you, rather. So we're graphing the equation x squared minus 3x equals minus 10 equals 0. I show you two different ways of putting it into Desmos. In the next slide, I will go over how I put that into Desmos and what that looked like. Here's an example of what your notes page should look like as you're taking notes as you go through this video. So I start with example 2 of x squared plus 4x equals 0. I show you how to sketch the graph. I show you how to label your roots on your paper. So please make sure that you take a second to really understand what we're looking for in terms of your notes for the graphing section. All right, so I'm going to turn off.
Walk you through how I... all the examples for solving by graphing notes into Desmos. So let's start with example 1, which is x squared. So I use the shift and the number 6 on your keyboard to get the exponent. If not, you can just use your keyboard down at the bottom. Minus 3x minus 10 equals y. Alright, so when you graph that, it gives you the parabola. So that's exactly what you see in the diagram that I created. And then you will also see a second graph next to it. So instead of setting it equal to y, if you set it equal to 0, it gives you the two x values. So x equals negative 2 and x equals 5. So those are the two roots that you have for the very first function. So then for example 2, I graphed that one for you and saw it on the back. So it is x squared plus 4x. This looks like this. And then again, if you set it equal to 0 instead of equal to y, it tells you that your roots are at negative 4 and 0. Those become x equals, which are vertical y's. Equation 3 is negative x squared plus 7. So for that one, your roots are at negative 2.646, and the second root is at positive 2.646. So equal to y, you can see the parabola there. So when you go to sketch the parabola on your notes page, this is what your parabola looks like. Go ahead and estimate where those two roots are between 2 and 3. And over on the left is between 2 and negative 3. And then your y-intercept is at 7. And then for example 4, we have x squared minus 3x plus 10. There's your graph. This one is no solution because it does not cross the x-axis, so there are no roots here. And then the final example, which is example 5, is x squared plus 2x. Plus 2x plus 1 equals y. And this one is what your parabola looks like. Your x-intercept is at negative 1. Your y-intercept is at 0, 1. So when you graph it, you can use those values. You can also try to estimate other values just to make sure your u-shape is correct. So this one is at negative 3, 4. And then in terms of your root, you only have 1. called a double root. We'll talk more about that when we get to the graphing section. But your root for this one is at -1, 0.
Alright guys, so that's it for this video. Please make sure that you got all the notes, anything that you need to go back, rewind, pause. You have all those options. Please let us know if you have any questions.